Hi, I'm John Kupal. After Proposition 13's success, bureaucrats look for new ways to raise revenues while getting around Proposition 13's restrictions. They hit upon assessment districts, which historically had been used to fund capital improvements that directly benefited property. Over time, local officials molded assessments into property taxes that avoided Proposition 13's limits. They also went to court and succeeded in undermining Proposition 13's requirement that local taxes be submitted to the voters. To counter these attacks on taxpayer rights, the Howard Jarvis Taxpayers Association qualified Proposition 218, the Right to Vote on Taxes Act, for the November 1996 ballot, where it was approved by the voters of the state of California. Proposition 218 gives people the right to vote on all local taxes and requires property owner approval of benefit assessments and property-related fees. Here's how it works in less than 2 minutes. Proposition 218 requires all local governments to get majority voter approval for new or increased general taxes, those taxes that go to the general fund and are allocated in the normal budget process. This closed a court-created loophole in Proposition 13. Proposition 218 provides stricter rules on benefit assessments on property by requiring that an agency must determine the specific benefit the project will have on individual parcels of property. It is no longer sufficient to justify an assessment by saying that the benefit provides a general enhancement to property values, which had been the case before Proposition 218. Proposition 218 increases notification and protest requirements. Agencies must put all assessments, charges, and user fees to a vote of property owners prior to the creation or increase. In most cases, property owners must be notified by mail of their opportunity to cast a protest vote. A formal protest hearing is also now required. Proposition 218 prohibits local governments from using assessments or fees to charge property owners more than the cost of providing the service. Finally, Proposition 218 provides voters the right to use the initiative process to reduce or repeal any existing local tax, fee, charge, or assessment. Because of Proposition 218, the Right to Vote on Taxes Act, you now have a say over your taxation. Thanks for listening. For more information on this and other subjects of importance to taxpayers, please visit our website at hjta.org.